hurt you, but you go ahead and say, you know what? I'm marching towards my end. Yes. I'm about to face this thing in the face. Jesus. The moment that you do that and you begin to go ahead and say, God, I know I don't got it all together. Lord God, I'm still making mistakes, Lord God. But I know, Lord God, you place something on the inside of your future to die here.
Lord Jesus.
I refuse to die at the gate of breakthrough. I'd rather die fighting my enemy. So I'm going to open my mouth. And God said, the moment that you open up your mouth and be real, the moment that your enemy left everything intact, he didn't take nothing with him. Woo! So that means your enemy didn't steal no peace, he didn't steal no new joy, he didn't steal no horses. No, he didn't take nothing with him. The Bible says they left with what was on their backs and ran the opposite direction. They left all their treasure, all their horses, all their new clothes, all their swords, all their shields. The enemy even left his weapons. That means the enemy can't even fight you. The enemy can't stab you. He can't go ahead and prick you. He can't go ahead and try to chop you down. No, he left his weapons in the camp. So you mean to tell me, God, as soon as I became real and I started saying, you know what, thank you, Jesus. I thank you for when you push me, even though I don't know what you're doing, Lord God. You went ahead and allowed me to go into the enemy camp, not take back what he stole from me, but take his stuff. Oh, see, the church wants us to focus on what the enemy stole from us. No, I'm past that point. I'm past what the enemy stole from us. No, I'm about taking his stuff.
That's right, my God.
You see, I'm going to take his stuff. I'm going to take his weapons and use his weapons against him.
Woo! Yes, God.
I'm going to take his words and spin them things and be like, oh. They go there, and this is what happens. Now, I didn't go all the way through the narrative, but they said after verse 8, they said the lepers go ahead and gather up everything that they could. Matter of fact, now this is what tripped you out. These four men are the richest lepers in the Bible, period. Hold on. When I was Gehazi before my issue, I wasn't rich. I was just connected to promise. But in spite of my issue, the thing that I wanted that was my mistake that got me off track, trying to take money, trying to get money, God goes ahead and blesses me with riches in spite of me falling apart. I'm a leper, and I told you they're the richest lepers in the Bible now. So in spite of me falling apart, God still blesses me with the thing that I desired in the first place, but I went after too quick.
Oh, no.
I told Naaman, no, I need some money. And that got me leprosy. But when God put it in my spirit to go after it, I got it with no strings attached. When I got these riches, I didn't get another disease. When I went after this piece, I didn't have strings attached. The Bible says, God, the blessings of God make it rich and add no sorrow. Basically, it doesn't have calamity of it. So I can go ahead and beg the difference. A lot of our blessings, we got to understand, are they something that God has sent or something that the enemy has sent as a booby trap or a distraction to go ahead and bring you further in the bond.
That's a good try. That's a good try.
The blessings of the Lord make it rich. They prosper you. And it's a TH on the end of it. Basically, it's a continual process. It doesn't add.